Good afternoon, everybody. This moment is very important to me to have time to share my atomic bomb experience. It's not so easy. We suffer, still we're suffering. But we believe all survivors stopped talking our experience. The history could repeat again any place. This moment, more than 3,000 nuclear weapons are ready to launch any moment. The world is under threat of nuclear arsenal. So this is very important moment to understand what really happened in Hiroshima, Nagasaki, 6-9 of August 1945. I was 6 years old. We are living 1.5 miles from the hypocenter, that means 2.5 kilometers. As a child, I used to go to the mountain to catch the insect like a dragonfly or cicadas. With my friend of my age, because we didn't have any kind of toy to entertain with. But that day, I was praying by myself in front of the house, close to my mother, who was preparing midday meal. That day, there were 3 times emergency siren, that means imminent air raid. But nothing happened. So people were doing everyday life. But a neighbor passed by said, a mysterious airplane flying over the city, so we must be very careful. Mother said, nothing going to happen as usual. That was true. City was Nagasaki, wasn't suffer much like big city Tokyo, Osaka, Nagoya, Fukuoka. Almost all big city were completely devastated by air raid, but especially by incendiary bomb. So many people die by fire, not by bomb. But that moment, my sister was inside of the house, came to my mother, said, Mother, on the radio, announcing a mysterious airplane flying over the city. So we must be very careful. In that moment, my mother called me in case we are going to enter in our private shelter. Private shelter means those almost all Japanese houses dig a small hole under the floor to use in case they didn't have enough time to go to the community center. They could build that place. My mother took my hand. The moment we entered the house came very strong flash, like a thousand lightning at the same time. It was very strong. So my mother pulled me down on the floor, covered my body with hers. Then came very strong explosion. We felt nothing flying over our body. Then, total silence. So we stood up. We saw the window, the doors, the roof were disappeared. We couldn't understand such a destruction. Then we crawled to the shelter. Already my sister was there. She was crying. My mother asked her what happened. She said, "Mother, I think I got oil." Oil means those days United States was going to use the chemical weapon, but no one understood what kind of chemical weapon. So people normally said could be like kind of oil, because my sister was feeling some oily liquid running down from her head. But we couldn't see anything in that moment because the place was so dark. We stayed there about 10 minutes. The moment my mother decided to take us to the community center, we came to the light. We saw my sister's head covered, very small piece of glass. She was bleeding. Fortunately, injury wasn't so profound. My mother took off all these small pieces of glass, cleaned up the blood. Then we dashed to the shelter in the mountain. But I want to mention here, my sister, when she was 5 years old, by accident amputated one of her legs. She was using a prosthesis. Those days, a prosthesis wasn't so comfortable. She suffered. She couldn't walk like a normal person. That reason, she couldn't attend the school. In case of emergency, she couldn't behave like other students. It was prohibited to her attend the school, so she was staying at home. But the moment we dashed to the shelter, she ran much faster than we did. It was first time and last time I saw her behave like a normal person. I guess she was so scared what happened, so reacted that way. In the community center, already many neighbors were there. Everybody was so scared, didn't understand what happened. We had heard 3 days before, city of Hiroshima was destroyed by very strong bomb, but no, we don't know it was atomic bomb. Then, 30 minutes after, children went to the mountain to catch the insect, came back. One of the children, he got very severe burn on his back. Almost his back was destroyed. He died about 2 days after. There's no doctor, no nurse, no medicine at all. His burn was infected with maggot. From the shelter, we could see our city of Nagasaki was burning day after day. We just watching our city was burning. No one said anything. We didn't have any word. We were kind of shocked. No one could say any word. But the problem was, there's no food at all. Before the blast, city of Nagasaki was providing a small amount of food, but after the blast, nothing. We were starving. We wanted to eat anything around us, grass, leaves, anything, but nothing we couldn't find. So my mother decided to take us to the countryside with our relatives. They are farmer, so my mother thought maybe they have some amount of food up for us. For that reason, we walked through close to the hypocenter. There were many corpses still. Total desolation. Everything burned up. People walking like a ghost. Anyway, our relative didn't have enough food for us. So we walked through again, hypocenter, to try to reconstruct our normal life. It was so difficult to get some amount of food. We made a trip by train every day to countryside, taking 1 hour or 2 hours, and also taking special kimonos or jewelry or something valuable things to exchange with some amount of food, like a potato or sweet potato. Rice is not possible to get. Money wasn't useful. You cannot use any money. So life continued difficult, but we survived. After I graduated high school, I started work, but at the same time, I started suffering by severe anemia. I was losing a lot amount of blood. I fainted out on the street, the restaurant, and the theater, anywhere. That happened every 6 months. Doctors practiced on me many times, endoscopy or blood test, but they couldn't find out the reason why I was losing a lot amount of blood. But the time passed. 2 years after, I had quite normal health, so I started work at the Atomic Bomb Hospital in Nagasaki. by recommendation of a friend of mine. Until that moment, I never thought I am atomic bomb survivor. But in the hospital, many people were dying every day. The people were suffering by cancer, different kind of cancer, especially leukemia. One special case, a guy about 20 years old, he was suffering by leukemia. I had same type of blood of him, so in case of emergency he needed blood transfusion, the doctor called me, Yasuaki, we need your blood, could you give us? So I did when I could, but one day his body was covered with black spot. He died. That moment, I said, this is my case. I'm going to die like him. I don't know when. Tomorrow, or day after tomorrow, or 1 month, or one year after. But I am sure I'm going to die like him. So it was so difficult to continue working in the hospital. I was running away or disappearing someplace because those days we are suffering also by discrimination by Japanese people. That reason, because after the blast, many people entered into the hypocenter looking for the family member, children, or friends. They were contaminated by radioactivity. No one knew what was happening there. All of a sudden, those people started dying. There's no, apparently no reason, no injury, no any disease. So the people didn't suffer by the blast, started saying, sure, the survivor carrying some kind of contagious disease. We must separate them. We must have any contact with them. We must any kind of friendship. We don't marry them. So many women suffer by that discrimination. Also men also, but women. Many women left the city of Hiroshima in Nagasaki to have normal life and have children, marry someone, but all of a sudden, people discovered they are from Hiroshima in Nagasaki, divorce. So many women couldn't stand such a discrimination, committed suicide. Many women did. Also, men did also. So I was suffering also by discrimination. And at the same time, the guy died by leukemia. So I was running out from Japan, anywhere, doesn't matter. But no one knows me, I am atomic bomb survivor. Then, 1968, I had a chance to come to Mexico. It was Olympic game in Mexico City. So I quit my job in the hospital. I came to Mexico. After the Olympic Games, the time passed about 2 years. I started suffering by severe anemia also. I was losing a large amount of blood. I faded out again. So doctors practiced on me endoscopy or blood test, but they couldn't find anything, any reason. So one day I told my friend, I said, I am atomic bomb survivor, but please don't tell anyone, because I don't want suffer again in Mexico. He said, okay, no problem. So the time passed until 1995. One day, I received a phone call from the son of my friend. He said, Yasuaki, are you atomic bomb survivor, right? So how do you know? I asked. He said, I heard from my father. My father heard from your friend. So he said, could you come to our university to give your atomic bomb experience? I said, no. It's very painful. It's not possible. But he insisted, because it's important to understand what's happened. The reason was, in 1995, France tested hydrogen bomb Ululua Atoll. So the news spread out all over the world, in Mexico too. He heard that news, so he wanted to understand more what happened in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So finally I accepted his invitation. At the beginning, I suffered. It was almost impossible, but I could finish my testimony. The moment I finished, I felt my pain was disappearing. So I said, this is kind of therapy to me. I must share my experience. I must talk. And also, it's important, if all the survivors stop to talk our experience, history could repeat again any moment. So since then, when I have opportunity accept their invitation, go to the high school, go to the university or public in general and United Nations, and since from 2012, I have been going New York, invitation by Hibakusha Stories Group. This is non-government organization. They invited many Hibakusha to come. Hibakusha means it's an atomic bomb survivor in Japanese. And they invited many atomic bomb survivor to come to New York and visiting high school to share our experience. Since then, we've been working, having contact with many high school students, so far over 30,000 high school students we had contact, sharing our atomic bomb experience. It is not so easy. Still, we suffered. After 74 years, we still suffering mentally, physically, psychologically. This suffering continues second or third generation by mutation of gene. So we must stop completely to use nuclear weapon anywhere. We don't want you suffered like we suffered. Could happen any moment because the situation is not good enough. So we must say we don't need nuclear weapon. We cannot live with nuclear weapon. Our average age of survival, over 82 years old. So our time is ending. We don't have enough time to continue to sharing our experience. So we need your help. Young people, especially young people, are going to have enough time to eliminate all the nuclear weapons in this planet. These more than 15,000 nuclear weapons could destroy our planet many times over. So you can take action. You can share this experience, your friend or your brothers and sisters or their family, with your neighbor. Tell this experience. And maybe you think the action you take is not big enough, it's not worth, but the action, even small action you take, make big wave. If you drop a tiny stone into the water make a big wave. So your action also could make a big wave. And one day, we believe to live without threat of nuclear weapon. It's very necessary because one nuclear weapon could destroy our planet. It's much powerful than two atomic bombs in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Imagine in Hiroshima, died 140,000 people that moment of explosion. In Nagasaki is 77,000 still dying. So we must say we don't want to live with nuclear threat any moment. It's possible. We take action because everyone could understand it's possible because human beings have enormous capacity to understand each other, to love each other. We don't must have hate to anyone. Hate create another hate, no ending at all. Hate produce war. So we must love each other to have peaceful life. Your life is so beautiful. We don't want your life destroyed instantly by nuclear weapon. Thank you very much.